Hey, my name's Jon Gries, otherwise known as Uncle Rico and a couple other 100 people, and I'm watching campusports.net.
You're watching Time Out on campusports.net.
Watch this.
What the heck are you doing?
That's what I'm talking about.
All right, campusports.net, I'm Dave Osco, and we are here with Jon Gries.
Dave.
Also known as Uncle Rico.
Sometimes.
Sometimes. Now, I got to tell you, it is an absolute honor to be sitting here with you.
Oh, man.
You are a legend.
That's not what he was saying before the cameras were rolling.
One of the greatest character actors of our time. You've done over 130 roles. You played a drug dealer in 90210.
Way back in the day.
You were on Seinfeld.
Yeah, yeah.
You were in all the Taken movies.
Yeah.
And of course, you know, your role in Napoleon Dynamite.
Napoleon Dynamite. Get Shorty.
Get Shorty.
Real genius.
Yeah, you've done a lot of stuff. And you act and direct. Correct?
Yes, I act and direct. And write, too. But, you know, I just kind of write for fun.
Right. Okay. Whatever works.
Yeah, hey, you know, if it gets published one day, you never know.
That's right. Now, I want to talk to you a little bit about this Uncle Rico character.
Yeah.
Because, again, in colleges and in universities across the country, it is, you know, the stuff of legend. And Uncle Rico in particular is one of the most...
Because it's meant to be that way, man. Come on.
One of the most quoted characters in film, I think.
Yeah,
just an awesome, awesome character. So tell me a little bit about that experience and that role and how that all happened.
You know, the interesting thing about that part was playing Uncle Rico was, believe it or not, before that had happened, I had quit acting. I was writing every day.
Okay.
And a friend of mine, Jory Weitz, who ended up casting Napoleon Dynamite, cast this film called The Big Empty with Jon Favreau and Daryl Hannah and Kelsey Grammer. And a guy had dropped out and he called me and he was like, dude, come, just come. I didn't have an agent. I just walked away. I had done 4 years on a TV show, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna do the paradigm shift. I'm gonna be a writer, and that's the way it's gonna go. Anyway, so he called me, and I ran out there, and I played this part. And while they were cutting that part, the people from Napoleon Dynamite, Jared Hess and Jeremy Kuhn, were using the office that they were editing that movie to cast Napoleon Dynamite, and Jory Weitz was, they'd made an offer for a couple people and they turned the film down. Mm-hmm. And Jory said, let's just take a look at this guy from this film that we just did, The Big Empty. And they saw the role and they just said, let's make an offer. So they just flat out offered it to me. I had no idea who these guys were. I knew nothing. And my manager, of course, was like, at that time I finally got a manager, and he was like, these guys, who are these guys? They, you know, never heard of them. You should really reconsider. I said, let me read the script. I read the script. By page 15, I was laughing out loud. I called my manager. I said, I will drive myself. I'll drive myself there. I'll do it.
Right.
And so that's how it happened. It was just, you know, one of those things. You know, when you read scripts, you can be in a bad mood and your whole outlook to the script can change. It just so happened that day I read the script. I got it.
Yeah.
I just got it.
Now, this has been an interview with Jon Gries. We're going to take a timeout on Time Out, and we're going to be right back with Uncle Rico.
How much you want to make a bet I can throw a football over the mountains?
Well, Uncle Rico's got a sale to finalize in Bonita in 5 minutes.
Oh, and you know we can't afford the fun pack. What do you think, money grows on trees in this family? Take it back.
All right, we're back, campusports.net, with Uncle Rico. He is here.
I just got one thing to say. You ain't gonna find no deflated balls here. We play them full.
All right, Uncle Rico, it is an absolute pleasure to be with
go
you
out for a
right
pass.
Now.
Go out for
I'm
a
going
pass.
To. I'm going to. Give me some time here. Now, yesterday I was in a charity game.
Heck yeah.
And I like this. This is a good look for you.
That's all right. Pay no attention to the man behind the wig and the fake mustache.
I was at a charity game yesterday. Kurt Warner was there.
Why wasn't I there?
You weren't available.
I could have been thrown.
I know you could have, but your agent wouldn't let you come.
Yeah, I know.
You wanted too much money.
No, not for charity. Don't say that. That's going to spread the wrong kind of idea. I can do charity for free.
I actually think
I have a special charity. It's called the Uncle Rico Charity for ex-wives.
I think you were out selling Tupperware, actually. You had a big Tupperware conference or something like that.
Well, we do that, and we do Bus Must Plus. We do whatever we got to do.
Now, Kurt Warner, Matt Leiner, when your name came up,
I
asked about some of the greatest arms in football.
Oh, yeah.
And they said, hands down, Uncle Rico. Shock, awe, a reverence towards you. How does that make you feel as an athlete?
Well, I'll tell you, the fact that none of the team owners saw that.
Yeah.
You know, I wanted to play alongside Peyton Manning because I think I had some things I could show him, but he's respectful. That's my bird.
I like
over
it.
There. That's actually my cheering section right over there. I got a single bird. No, but she goes long. Come on now. What's up? What's up? You ready? Are you ready for me? Come on. I'll put a hole right in the wall.
Now, those owners, what do you think it was? You know, you did a great time at the Combine.
I did.
You ran a very fast 40.
Marcellus.
I think you were
he took good care of me.
Well, your first time was around 5 seconds, and then I think you finished at 7-1, correct?
Yeah, well, my legs were a little weak.
Yeah, that second run.
Well, I didn't have the proper cleats on. I think I was wearing my street shoes.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Now, you have an incredible throwing motion.
I do.
It's something like I've really never seen.
Well, I've developed it into three different kinds. I got this one.
Right.
I got that one. And I got that one.
Oh, behind the back.
Yeah, yeah. But that's just in case somebody coming the wrong way.
That's impressive.
Probably. It's also called fumble.
All right. Now, I'm going to put you in what we call the timeout penalty box.
Okay, let's do it.
A few questions.
All right.
You just need to answer as quickly as possible. All right?
Yeah.
Uncle Rico, favorite color?
Man, whatever team shirt, jersey I'm wearing.
Favorite fast food restaurant?
I don't eat fast food.
What do you eat?
Man, I eat, well, steak.
Steak?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, not really. But
you like
go
my
ahead.
Bacon right here.
Yeah,
huh?
That's right. I'm going to eat this bacon.
Now, you're a meat eater, but Jon Gries is a vegetarian,
meat
correct?
Eater. I am. Uncle Rico's a meat eater.
Right.
Jon Gries?
Yeah.
See, it's tall. True character acting when you get, you know, it's method acting.
Right.
You got to eat the steak.
Yeah. No, I understand.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, you got to grow the mustache.
Of course. Your favorite holiday?
Well, my favorite holiday is summer.
Favorite number?
I'm going to say 72. No, 8. It's infinity.
8?
Eight.
Oh, infinity.
Right. Yeah.
And if you could be a superhero, who would you want to be?
I want to be Uncle Rico as a quarterback.
As a superhero?
No, as a superhero, I don't really believe in superheroes. I think they're blown up too much.
Okay. Too publicized.
They're too overdone. Yeah, man. If I was gonna be a superhero, I'd be totally different from every other superhero.
All right. Now, we're going to take it out on the field right now.
Yeah, let's do it.
This has been a timeout with the great Uncle Rico. I'm Dave Osico. We'll see you next time.
We're happy to be here. Thank you. Canvas Sports.